In Affinity Photo, you can now select an image, move tool, press return, and a move duplicate panel will pop up. And you can enter values, say like rotation, 40, duplicate, number of copies, say 12, and it will duplicate those objects all the way around. And then click OK. But there's a few things before you do this that you might find interesting and useful. So I've got this, best thing to do, layer and make certain it's rasterized. Because if you've selected it, copied it from somewhere else, you might find the thing's massive and it will create some unusual color effects when you use that power transform feature. Okay, once you've got that, you'll also notice I've got this. If I didn't have that, it would just rotate around this object, which is fine, but I don't want that. So what I want is here, enable transform origin, and you can reposition it. So you can put it up there and everything you do in the duplication will be done around that position, not around this. Also, you'll notice when you duplicated it, all of them are all separate layers, but you can actually make them also duplicate links, so they're all linked, so any change to one will change in all the others. How to do that? Go to layer and duplicate linked. As soon as you've done that, you can see now you've got this link between the two. This is one of the most powerful features. It's a bit like symbols in Affinity Designer. Really, really useful. But now, with that one selected, I can go and press return and it will rotate around that or move around that. And I'm going to set it, say, to 20. Rotation. Number of copies, so duplicate. And I'm going to set it, say, to 17. So you've got those duplicated. Click OK. All of them now are duplicate linked. But you'll notice they've gone over the edge, which I'm not too keen on. If you go over the edge in these things, quite often you might end up cropping things. So I'm just going to select them all and slightly resize it. So it's just... Now, of course, just create a really big document to work with so you avoid this sort of thing where it cuts off. So it would just cut it off and you might find when you apply effect, you lose part of the image. So now you've got those. You can select any of the layers. You choose any of them. So go to filters and distort and you can use any of these filters as well. I'm just going to use deform. So deform and click add some pins. With those, as you change it, you notice what happens. They all change. You can see that distorts the entire image. You distort it that way. And so on and so on. You can create literally thousands, like I say, maybe use mirror or any of the others. And there, you've got that. Now, again, I will select, make certain that you avoid going over the edge. So just select all of them. With them all selected, you can then resize them. Make sure you select them all. Otherwise, if some are not selected, it won't resize all of them. So select them all and then resize. Again, just avoid going over that edge of the document. Then go to layer and merge visible. So they all merge into a single pixel layer. And you can, of course, distort them and modify them in numerous other ways. And this also can be used with the move tool and press return to bring up the duplicate. You can just go here and now this time it will rotate around this. Put duplicate and you can set it to say 12 and rotation say 20. And you can see, obviously, there is a, once you do that, make certain it's a value that actually helps to actually display the design. Now, unfortunately, there's no scaling feature. I would love to have seen a scaling feature in this as well. Would have made it a really helpful panel, but it's still super useful for all kinds of transform designs. Well, I hope you found this of interest. Any questions, please let me know in the comments below. Also, a like or dislike, always appreciated. Please also subscribe to the channel. Bye.